Predicting the future is a difficult task, but in the business world we try, with a market known as the Futures Exchange, essentially forecasting what the prices of valuable commodities will be in the future. But what if the futures market concept was applied to real-life events? At the University of Iowa, researchers have done exactly that with an innovative project called the Iowa Electronic Markets. The IEM, as it is known, is a group of online futures markets operated by the Tippie College of Business. Like an actual exchange, the IEM allows participants to trade standardized futures contracts, agreements to buy or sell a commodity at a point in the future for a set price. Instead of commodities, contracts in the IEM are based on real-world events like corporate earnings, stock price returns, and, of course, elections. Professor Tom Reitz is one of the researchers operating the Iowa Electronic Markets.
The way we structure the futures markets in the IEM is we say, well, in November there'll be an election, and that election will result in a winner, and there will be a popular vote split between the two. So we just trade a contract that pays off in November, just like a corn futures contract will pay off in November, except ours are tied to the election outcome.
In the 2008 election, the IEM predicted the final vote count to within half a percentage point. In comparison to more than 900 polls over the last two decades, the IEM has been closer to the actual outcome 74% of the time. Iowa's Political Science Department, which pioneered election forecasting, acknowledges the accuracy of the IEM.
It's a market strategy, it's a trading market. Now there's more than one. The IEM was the first, it's the best. You take the final IEM forecast, the final Gallup forecast, the IEM is better.
While the IEM would appear more accurate than polls, Iowa scholars believe polls can be misinterpreted.
Pollsters are trying to measure current opinion and the ebb and flow of current opinion through time. They're not necessarily trying to forecast the election.
Polls are really volatile, and that volatility is artifactual. It's not real. It's really not public opinion is changing that much every day.
Researchers point to the way the prediction markets aggregate trader information as one reason for their accuracy.
Now, the nice thing about the election market that we run is that there's kind of an automatic mechanism for getting rid of biases. If a trader comes into our market and they're heavily biased, what they typically do is they come in and they spend their entire budget on that candidate's contracts and then they hold them until the election. Since they've stopped trading, they stop setting the market prices that we use as our forecast. What we've noticed is that the people that buy and sell continuously, that are always setting bids and asks, that are trading back and forth, tend to be unbiased.
Kurt Hunter, dean of the Tippie College of Business at Iowa, says the promise of the IEM goes far beyond political forecasting.
These markets are really interesting because they elicit information that you would not normally get by just taking a poll. We're not even aware of all the applications that these markets could have.
We're working in a variety of areas, revenues of new products, the flu, elections. We've even run markets on where hurricanes will strike. We're sort of at the cutting edge of forecasting.
With a 20-year history, the IEM is an enduring symbol of Iowa's strengths in finance, economics, and political and social sciences.
It was a natural thing for us. I mean, this is where Gallup did his training. This is sort of the origin of scientific polling.
We are the forecasting world. If you want to study this, this is a place to come.
Today, the IEM continues to be a valuable teaching and research tool.
At a basic level, this really engages the students.
It allows us to use it as a teaching tool where we can bring together our students and our faculty around these different events to talk about how you might forecast in a more informative and accurate way. So this relates to our mission as a college, integrity, innovation, and impact. And I think this is an example of an application coming out of the college that hits it on all three levels.
To learn more about Tippie College of Business and the Iowa Electronic Markets, visit biz.uiowa.edu/IEM.